Thank you. Can you all hear me? I see thumbs up, so I'll go ahead. I'm sorry I couldn't be there with you, but I want to talk about a very important topic. And that topic is Europe. How we in Europe can regain our competitive advantage and again take a leadership position globally. So my take is that there is still time. There is still time for Europe to take that leadership position, especially in the field of supply chain. But it's not going to be easy, and we don't have a lot of time. And if we accomplish this, Europe will be able to solve some of the biggest global problems facing humanity today. And that is emissions, that is waste, that is traffic deaths. I'm Jonas Hernlund. I'm the Global Chief Commercial Officer at EINRIDE. EINRIDE is the global leader in autonomous electric technology. We are the leader in our space, but very few of our peers are actually from Europe. Most of them are in the US or Asia, and we want to change that. Because, I mean, we love Europe. Europe is home to some of the biggest innovations solving for humanity today, especially in the supply chain space. For example, the railway was born here in 1804 in the UK. The combustion engine was born here, and modern trucking was born here as well. But for the last decades, we've seen a significant slowdown in our innovation as a region compared to our peers in the US and in Asia. And just picking up just one data point, one example to show this, is the level of investments in artificial intelligence. If you compare to the US, we invest roughly one third. And if you compare to Asia, we invest half. And if you extrapolate that line, what this means, this is not a good position to be in. And for us in the industry and everyone in the broader supply chain and technology ecosystem in Europe, now this is painfully visible when we look at our various policies and regulations, both at the EU level and at state and commune level. For example, in the autonomous drive space, we can take a look at an example from Volkswagen, where they have a very clear ambition with the launch of their Cedric vehicle in the US first, then a couple of other markets, and then Europe. Quote, "We would love to come earlier since it's our home market, but the legislation just isn't there." So, what is it that we need to do in Europe? If I can just get my... So we need to get our act together. Number one, we need to make it simpler to do business here. What would happen if we as a region commit to a shared commitment to make our legislation the most progressive in the world rather than the least progressive in the world? So that actually companies choose to do their R&D for autonomous drive in Europe rather than in California or Texas. I mean, the climate, we can't do much about the climate in Stockholm compared to California, but what about if we have the most progressive legislation? Secondly, let's make sure that Europe, compared to other regions, we have the most progressive set of investment schemes into future and green opportunities. And let's not hold on to the past, but aggressively invest towards the future. And I'm going to let you in on a little secret, and don't tell anyone. And this is probably the biggest business opportunity in the history of mankind. So remember, don't tell anyone. This is an opportunity for the real Green New Deal for Europe, where we really can make a difference for the world, not only for Europe. And so here comes the secret. So this is just pointing out a big global problem. And as you know, big global problems tend to come with sort of interesting, compelling both business cases and solutions if you solve them. So globally, the road freight transport market, it emits 5 billion barrels of oil every year. I'm going to let that number sink in for a while. 5 billion barrels of oil. That's 7% of all global CO2 emissions globally. And this is one of the few categories that is steadily increasing. So it's clear that this is a massive problem that needs to be addressed. And if you look at this from the, I don't know if we have any investors in the room today, but this is actually one of the biggest global markets out there that hasn't yet been disrupted by the digital revolution. This market is significantly bigger than any of the advertising markets that you have Google and Facebook operating on. It's significantly bigger than the cloud market. And this is a $2,000 billion opportunity worldwide. So in terms of A, is this a big global problem? And two, is this a big, big opportunity of a problem? The answer is yes. But as I mentioned, don't tell anyone about it. So I think, you know, this is a big, big Green New Deal for Europe that we can take on. And we can take it on globally. And EINRIDE and a set of European peers in the industry are taking this challenge head on, but we need the help of the rest of Europe. And we've come up together with our peers with a set of European hardware and software engineering that aims to solve for this big global problem. Here is a quick video of what we've been up to in this space. And really what we're doing is that we're building a new type of infrastructure. It's clean and it's significantly cost disruptive. It will reduce up to 90% of the CO2 and up to 60% of the cost for the shipping companies. And what you saw there in the video is the world's first commercial autonomous electric operation flow of goods. And this happened earlier this year, not in the US, not in Asia, but in Europe. And this is a picture from the test site in the southern part of Sweden. And as we speak, we are building this infrastructure from the ground up, starting with digitizing all of the road transport flows, driving electrification where possible, and gradually moving over to autonomous driven lanes. Where we see the business case and where we see the feasibility based on permits and based on technology and charging infrastructure. And if you look at the map, this is not the map of Europe. Our first country of expansion is the US, but we would love to do the same for Europe. But we need to make sure that the regulation welcomes us this type of innovation, welcomes this investment, and that we get the right prerequisites to do this. In order to build this type of infrastructure, you need a unique mix of hardware and software. So on the software side of things, we built a proprietary platform called the FMP, the Freight Mobility Platform. And this platform holds the key to understanding the best opportunities for electrification and for going on autonomous drive, leveraging more than 100 signals in real time, such as what is the topography of the lane? Is it uphill? Is it downhill? What's the wind conditions? What's the weather conditions? Obviously, driving in Los Angeles is different to Stockholm in December. And even such thing as if the driver has the air conditioner on or not in real time. And once we have that digital infrastructure in place, we'll start to introducing hardware products, starting with manually driven electric trucks, and then gradually automating those flows so we can reap that full cost disruption that we'll get for shipping customers. And that's where you see sort of this last piece of the hardware. We're calling this our pod. So this is the AET technology, autonomous electric technology. And this is that we saw in live operations in the video. These are trucks with a remote safety driver sitting in the live case that you saw. The remote safety driver that 250 kilometers from the actual driving seat, with an ability to control up to 10 trucks in parallel. And the pods, they do not have a driver cabin. They're completely engineered to be autonomous and electric from the ground up, which is what you need to do in order to get this piece of technology to work. So my take is, let's come on, Europe. Let's solve for some of the biggest global problems like we used to do. Let's simplify our bureaucracy and get the innovative EU companies the funding that they need. That was it from me. Really looking forward to a roundtable discussing some of these burning questions and how we as an ecosystem can evolve these problems forward. Thank you for me.